Ronnie sometimes is like, he's a pain in the ass because he wants to train too hard. He's like, he's brilliant, he's like, he's an amazing guy and all that. But yeah, you've got to slow him down yourself. He's like, I love people who are fit and want to train. And Ronnie goes, right now, Ronnie, you've got to chill today. I've only done 50 rounds. That's what he's like. Can do more. But like I say, he's got a big fight coming up with Denton. Denton's a top lad, he's a really good lad, he's a top fighter, very, very strong, very fit. But no one's seen what Ronnie can do yet. And I just hope to God he does what he's been doing in the gym on the fight night. He can make it an easy fight. If he don't, he can make it a very hard fight. But no one's seen Ronnie yet. And when they see what he can do, they'll start like standing up going, oof, the guy's...
Yeah. Just about right. Yeah. Now let's go. Yeah. Come on. Come on. Single.
Don't forget he turned pro young and it's maturity as well. He's fighting men and stuff and like one is one of them guys that just wants to blow it away sometimes and stuff. And these guys who took up and they know everything. They know like Peter McDonald and stuff, they've seen it all before. He's beat Lee Purdy, things like that. But Ronnie's got a little bit more experience now where he knows and he's been having really good sparring with Matthew, all people like that, Mark Thompson. It was better than Denton Vassell, in my opinion. Might not be everyone else's, but my opinion, better than Denton Vassell, so that's standing in good stead, and he's having really good spars with him.
I think there's a lot of credit goes to your camp and their camp for taking the fight.
Yeah. Cool, yeah, it's a hard fight. It's more hard, if you're looking from the outside, it's more harder for us, because Ronnie's, he's not sure what he's got yet, in my opinion. And he's still young. Denton's 28 years old. He's strong to what? He's a champion. But he's not boxed for a year. Don't care what anyone says. Oh, he has so much sparring. He's done this. He runs 50 miles a day and whatever. It doesn't matter. It's when you're in the ring activity. Ronnie could outfight Denton. He'll shock everyone. He could outfight him. But I don't want him to do that. I want him to... Well, not what I say what he's going to do, but I want him to box like we've been boxing in the gym. Bust him up, and then when he wants to, when he wants to, when he feels the time is right, he can set down his shots. But other than that, he's a boxer, he's been boxing, and he will bring that title home. I'm really, really confident.
Go on, Demola. Go on.
I took this fight. We got asked for this fight straight away. Like what I do straight away, even though I'll think yes, you can beat him, I'll phone them first and have a speaking. What? Yeah, but this and yeah, but that. No. Straight away, yeah. I won the fight straight away. It was like on his mouth. I won that fight. But the thing is, I know what he's like myself. So we talk about it. We have a long talk about it because I know what he's like. If I said to him, Manny Pacquaio, yeah. You know what I mean? He's one of them guys. Hey, boxers, huh? Boxers won't say no. But I know he believes 1,000,000% he can do it. And he will do it. I'm confident.
It's going to be a good fight because Denton comes to fight. It's a step up for me. It should bring the breast out, man. I'm looking forward to it. It's got a pretty good avenue for the first few rounds. Probably his body punches, he comes in, throws a lot of them. It's likes to put you on the back foot, he can use his strength. He's physically strong, isn't he? So he likes to put you back. It's going to be a tough fight because he's tough, strong, isn't he? So, yeah, now I fight.
I think Denton's a top guy. Really, I like Denton. He's a top lad. He used to train like the Fox, still train here when he was at the Fox. I was at the gym over the road, and he's training. He used to put on the pads and stuff like that. But Denton, then he was a welterweight, say now, but I think it was 69 kilo. So I welterweight then. So he's got four or five pounds to play with. And that was then. That was years ago when he was in the ABAs and stuff, and I thought he was strong and stuff. He's not a massive banger, but he's so strong and so fit. Great head movement. But taking that weight off him, it hurts him, man. No, it hurts him. Don't care what anybody says, it hurts him. It's going to hurt him Friday night. With Ronnie in as well, it's going to hurt him more. Ronnie will beat him and bring the title home. But Denton Vassell, obviously, I'm top guys. But it's a fight, innit? It's a fight. So we're here to fight. We're not here to play games. We're here to fight.
I can't see it being anything but a belter, really.
It's going to be a cracking fight. It can't not be a cracking fight, no matter what way Ronnie boxes, because Denton's going to come. He can't box him on the back foot, because he boxes him on the back foot, he's not going to land a shot on Ronnie. He's too short for that, so he's got to come. So he's got to make for a great fight, no matter what. It will be a brilliant fight. Looking forward to one that I'm really confident with, if Ronnie boxes like he boxes in there.
What are your attributes, your main strengths?
Mine, it's probably my jab. I get that going, I should be alright. My older brothers used to box, they stopped now, but I used to go to the gym with them, my dad used to take us. So me and Matt started. I just love boxing, I just like doing it. It's like coming into the gym and that, keeping fit, it's good.
But you're a boxing fan as well?
Oh yeah, I'm a boxing fan, yeah, I follow it a lot.
What fighters influenced you?
Ricky Hatton, when I was a kid, I used to watch him all the time. He's like my favourite fighter, still is.
So you base your style on him originally, did you?
Yeah, when I was younger, I used to, yeah.
Was you at the fight, his fight?
I didn't go to it, no.
Gutted,
he lost.
What British fighters at the moment do you admire in, you know, the pros?
In the pros, British. Probably Tony Bell, you were like, he's jabbing and he's a good fighter. When he used to train, I used to always like watch him. Probably one of my best pros now.
Mm. Have you been sparring anyone in particular for this fight with Denton?
I've been sparring Matt Yall, he's a bit bigger than Denton, and I've done a bit with Joe Hughes as well. That's some good sparring.
You're in good hands here, aren't you, with Arnie, and he's a great trainer, really dedicated. He tells me sometimes he has to slow you down a bit, because you're a real avid trainer, and it's always important for you to be 100% fit. So.
I know, you can overtrain, you can only go so far, can't you?
But he brings all the best out in you, doesn't he, Arnie?
Yeah, Arnie's a good trainer.
What sort of relationship do you have with him in that sense? You said you didn't speak to him for the first 4 years, is that right?
Oh yeah, I was quiet when I first come, but we're alright now.
You know, is he always teaching something new?
He's always learning, yeah, he's always practicing stuff. Yeah. Good trainer.
It's all down to him now. We've done all the hard work, all the training is finished. It's all about talking now and stuff and keeping his weight down. If he does what he does in here, keeps his composure, he'll win. He'll win that fight. No doubts in my mind.